Hello YouTube, welcome back. I'm dedicating this video to a new subscriber to my channel. He's a horticulturalist, his name is Ron, and the poor fellow has managed to watch every single one of my videos over about a 1 month period. Now I don't know why he's maintained his interest. I mean, these videos are pretty poor production quality and there's no fancy text or music or anything that would make it binge worthy, but he's done it. And Ron, to say thanks for watching all those videos, this one is just for you. Now, if, like Ron, you've been watching all my videos, this place will be familiar to you. This was a farm I first looked at when I was looking to buy a macadamia farm. But when I looked at it, there were double the numbers of rows of trees, and the inner part of that orchard was very dark and very grown over. The owners removed every second row and they just came along and just bowled the trees over, probably chipped them. I don't know if the chip was put back under the remaining trees. It does look like it was. Some agronomists say that that's a bad thing and that you should heavily prune the row that you're going to take first so that the remaining trees don't get a shock and don't get sunburn when you take out the middle row. But I'd have to say this experiment looks like it's succeeding. The trees do look happy. You can't see many silver tips or any signs of real stress. And you can see on average that the trees do seem to be growing sideways, making use of the available sunlight rather than struggling to grow up all the time, which is, you know, obviously a negative in terms of management on a number of issues. And the best comparison you can make is the orchard across the road from it, where the rows haven't been removed, and all you can see in between the rows there is darkness. There's no ground cover, there's root exposure in the trees, and the trees themselves are struggling to get up and reach the sunlight. Now, it's also fair to say that on neither side of the road are these trees bearing a crop, but they're largely 3-4-4s, and like my 3-4-4s, the rain during pollination has really crueled the crop, and so it's a very off year for those trees and probably a few Hawaiians generally, the ones that tend to drop early. So that's interesting. February, in the Southern Hemisphere at least, is the last chance farmers have to make amendments to the soil, that is, fertilise. And the reason for that is twofold. One is if you're fertilising, the nuts start dropping in March and you don't want trucks running over your nuts. And you also don't want to put things down like manures, which can be a bit of a pest with your nut processor, who doesn't want manures in with their macadamia nuts, and you'd be breaching your supply contract if you did. So February's pretty much your last chance. Now, in this year of tight budgeting, my agronomist and I thought we'd take a soil test of Nutkin Farm so that we wouldn't be spending money on things that we didn't need to spend on. And of course, you know, you've got to prioritise what you want to do. And in this particular season, my priority is fixing the soil, fixing the trees, and then not necessarily going all out for growth or crop or that sort of thing, like we did in the heady days where the prices were amazingly high and you were trying to squeeze every last nut out of the trees. So we did a soil test, and if you go the whole hog, you also do a leaf test, which together shows you what's in the soil and how much of it is getting through to the actual tree. But we just did a soil test this time, and I'm about to show you what that looks like. Now, they're done by a laboratory, and they give you results which have a lovely colour-based chart. You can see running up and down here, they'll have every mineral that you need for macadamias plotted against a template for what's ideal for macadamias, and it's not a great template. I'll come to that in a second. However, the bars here show green for light green for good, dark green for high, orange for marginal, red for deficient. And you can see right away I've got a deficiency of nitrate nitrogen. The reason for that is I'm not doing chemical feeds, and that's when you'll get nitrate nitrogen in the soil. Ammonium nitrogen, however, which comes from the manure base that I'm feeding, is actually very good. What I'm lacking is potassium, which isn't surprising, and calcium, which is something that does need addressing. But the interesting thing from all this, and I guess the most important part of the analysis for me, was the pH, the soil pH. That's the very top result there, coming in at 5.25. Now, it's showing up as being adequate because it says that normally the sufficiency range is 5 to 6.5 pH. Now, pH is a measure of soil acidity, but what it does is, you know, depending on how acid the soil is, it will make certain nutrients more or less available to the plants you're feeding. And there's a chart of that that I can show you, which is a scale of pH. Now, pH goes from 1 to 14. This is just showing sort of the middle of the range from 4 to 10. And it'll show you that when the soil is of a certain acidity, all these nutrients that the tree needs are more or less available to the plant. Now, my soil test says that the adequacy of pH is 5 to 6.5. The agronomists would be horrified at that because 5 is in fact a very acid soil. And once you've got a pH of 5 on this scale here, if you run down the line of 5, a whole lot of nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, the big three, are very weakly available to the plant when your soil is that acid. Same other things with sulfur and calcium, which is deficient in my soil. What becomes very available in an acid soil are things like iron, manganese, boron, copper and zinc, and molybdenum. And the other thing that's not shown in here is aluminium, which is toxic to a plant. When it becomes available to a macadamia tree, it starts to poison it. So it's the absolute last thing you need from acid soil. So agronomists would rather you have your macadamia's pH between 6 and 6.5, which is mildly acidic. Now, when you run down the line here, slightly acidic soil has very good availability of nitrogen, potassium, phosphorus, but and you know, reasonably optimal amounts of calcium, magnesium, and high availability of things like boron, copper, and zinc. So the metals in particular have a good availability in slightly acid soil. No one suggests that your pH should be 7, which is bang on neutral. But bang on neutral, everything is reasonably available as well. And I certainly wouldn't object if my soil was pH 7. Here in the Northern Rivers, however, volcanic soil, which is quite high in iron and sulfur and acidic-based minerals, you can get pHs sometimes as low as 4. Now, when I bought Nupkin Farm, I started off with a pH of 4.9 in one block and 5.0 in another. And over a couple of applications of one application of agricultural lime, which is just powdered limestone, and two applications of Auskal, which is a prilled lime, I've got the pH up to 5.25, 5.3 in my old blocks, which had quite bad acidity. For some reason, block one has fine acidity; it's up over 6. So the question is what to do about that. And so the prilled lime is actually super fine lime. It's been ground up really, really fine and then put into a prill so that when it gets broken down into the soil, it's more available to the plant. And the people selling you the prilled lime will say you only need to use a tenth as much in order to get the same effect on soil acidity. Now, I know it's had some effect because I've managed to shift the pH. It's a campaign that can take years. However, the prilled lime has not caused a major shift in pH. Now, when I got my soil test, my agronomist said, look, we could do prilled lime again, but he noticed that calcium in the soil test is at a real low, and that even though you only have to use 1 to 10 of prilled lime, when you need to actually supplement calcium to the trees as a nutrient, it's better to use agricultural lime, which is obviously 10 times the amount of calcium, but in a slower release format. And you can then do that reasonably safely, so long as you don't sort of overdo it. Now, as a budgeting decision, obviously I want the nitrogen, potassium, phosphorus in the soil to be more available to my trees. But if I just spend a lot of money dumping more nitrogen, potassium and phosphorus into acid soil, what I'm really doing is wasting my money, because there's a lot of nutrient already there, but it's locked up by the acid soil. So the best way to spend my money this February is to add lime to the soil. And this time we're going to do agricultural lime. And at a fairly hefty dose too, 5 tonnes a hectare. In the Northern Rivers, when you're doing agricultural lime, it gets shipped in from inland New South Wales, and the only really efficient way to get it shipped in is by the truckload, a truck and dog, and the truck and dog takes 30 tonnes of lime. So dividing that out with the 12 hectares I've got that need amendment, I'm going to get 60 tonnes in and spread that 5 tonnes a hectare. And hope we get some rain to rain it into the soil, because one of the disadvantages of getting in agricultural lime is that it's basically chalk dust, and it can blow all over your farm in a major way. And when it blows all over your farm, it's a pest, number one. It's not toxic or anything, but it's a pest. But also it doesn't get where it's needed, which is into the roots of your trees or around the root zone. So that's going to be the exercise for this February, in terms of maintaining my orchard and getting it ready for the next year. The plan is after that to put down some fertilizer, probably in between harvest rounds, so that I'm not disturbing too many nuts, but then sort of, you know, giving the trees bits of what they need nutrient wise to maintain them into the next year, and hopefully keep them happy. Then if you happen to have a good flowering season and everything else, well, there's a crop there that might be worth harvesting in 2024, depending on the price that they're offering for it that particular year. So guys, that's my update for now. Hope that you found the soil tests and things interesting. Most people wouldn't, but given that I've devoted this video to a horticulturalist, I thought I might show you anyway. Have a lovely day, whatever it is you're doing, and I will catch you again soon. Bye for now.